here at Evolve MMA. I'm gonna meet up with Amir Khan and Troy Worthen. They've just finished their training session for One King of the Jungle, but afterwards I figured we'd just, the three of us, hang out and chill. So this coronavirus outbreak, are you getting calls from your buddy back home about it?
Very start of it, I was getting a few messages and phone calls and people were asking what's up, but you know, I just kind of rest assured them that I practice good hygiene, my wife practices good hygiene, we make sure we shower, wash up.
I just want to point out right now, I mean, there are still kids, there are still families going out playing.
Life goes on, man.
Life goes on.
Life goes on.
So Chaudhry has confirmed that the Singapore event is going ahead, but behind closed doors. What were your thoughts when you heard?
I was just super excited that he made the decision to let us still compete. For me, as an entertainer, I like to feed off the crowd, but I'm just happy that I get to compete, so I will have no complaints.
Amir, for you, you've come off an impressive victory last time round. There was a lot of conversation after that bout about how it all went down and how your arm was raised at the end. But you want to prove those naysayers wrong.
I mean, all my teammates, all my coaches know what I'm capable of. Mm-hmm. But I just got to show it on fight night.
Do you know what Kimihiro is capable of?
2 years ago, we used to train together. We are really aware of each other's styles. And I've really trained really, really hard for this fight. And yeah, I feel I'm ready for him anywhere the fight takes place.
At the end of the day, with nobody in that room, we're still fighting in one championship. We're still fighting some of the top guys in the world. And there's still millions of people around the world
Everyone's
watching.
Everyone's still watching it.
We understand that there's still eyes on it and we're still competing at the highest level. There might not be in the same room as us and it's a little bit harder to feed off that, but just knowing that I get to go out there and compete on the world stage.
All right, so before we wrap things up, guys, quick predictions. Obviously, you're both looking for that W, but how do you see it going down?
You know, I have two fights that ended late second round stoppages, TKO, ground and pound, and maybe I'll try and keep that, like make that a thing. We'll say another second round TKO.
Second round TKO, all right. How about you, yourself, Amir?
Like I said, this year I'm going back to my finishing ways. Usually when I finish a guy, it'll be not more than 2 rounds.
Hey guys, I'm here at Yoga Movement at Robertson Quay waiting on Singapore's very own Tiffany Teo to finish up her yoga class. Afterwards, I figure maybe we grab a cup of coffee, talk about her upcoming bout at One King of the Jungle, and who knows, if I'm lucky, she might even show me around Robertson Quay. First things first though, I didn't know you did yoga.
Oh yeah, I've been doing it for a long time, many years,
Seriously, just when I thought I knew everything about you, I didn't know about this.
Yeah, always something new.
So you're feeling refreshed?
Yeah, feeling really good.
What do you think, cup of coffee? Can I treat you to a cup of coffee?
Yeah, it's a cafe just right by the studio, can check it out.
Listen, this is your town, this is your hood, you
All
take
right,
me.
I'll show you around.
All right, let's do it. Everything is self-contained in here.
It is.
Oh, yes.
Yes, thank you.
I didn't know that about you, Tiff. I mean, you balance your mixed martial arts training with yoga.
Yeah, I think it's a good balance. MMA is really pretty hardcore, the training.
Sure.
So I like to do something more relaxing, take my mind off training. Yeah.
I think it's really interesting that this is a side of you that people don't really tend to see. I mean, obviously they see you in action inside the circle.
Yeah, I know.
But here you are relaxing, drinking peppermint tea and doing yoga. Well, speaking of relax, how relaxed are you leading up to One King of the Jungle here in Singapore?
I'm really excited. Yeah, looking forward to get back to One Championship. And also this time around in Singapore.
Behind closed doors.
Yeah.
You're not injured, which is great. And Ayaka Miura is...
From Japan.
From Japan.
Yeah.
She's your opponent.
Yeah.
Have you studied her?
Yeah, a little bit. So pretty confident going into this fight.
Do you have a strategy in mind?
Yeah, a rough strategy. I mean, you can always have a plan.
Sure.
But if things don't go according to plan, you have to, you know, improvise and adapt. Yeah.
How is that going to mess with your psyche, if at all, being in an empty arena?
Yeah, it's really interesting because it's still at the indoor stadium, empty arena. It's like everything will be amplified, you know, every punch you throw. And yeah, so I'm not too sure what to expect because it's my first time, you know, fighting in an event with no
crowd.
Yeah, no crowd, no audience. Yeah, I'm looking forward to it too. Should be a pretty interesting experience. Yeah.
All right. So what do you say we finish these up and head down to Robertson Quay?
Yeah, sure. It's a really nice view there too.
Yeah. Yeah. All right, well, cheers.
All right, cheers.
I have to say, not being from Singapore myself, I could see myself living here.
Oh, nice.
you know, this is something that that people also don't see in the press. And you guys need to chill.
Yeah, just calm down.
You've got nothing to worry about so long as you are vigilant, so long as you stay healthy.
Yeah,
this is great. I'm glad that you and I got to hang out, spend some time one-on-one. Next time I see you,
in the circle.
We'll be in the circle at the Singapore Indoor Stadium.
Yes.
I wish you all the very best.
Thanks.
And I look forward to calling your name.
Yeah, looking forward to that
weekend.
Too. Yeah.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.